Morning, students. So welcome to first a demonstration on experiment on physics. Okay. So total actually we are having 12 experiments which is given on the prescribed in our syllabus. And out of that 10 experiments, sorry, 12 experiments, we have to do 3 to 5 experiments minimum. Okay. So today onwards, 3 to 5 experiments. Maximum we will try to complete 5 experiments. We will be completing in the demonstration part, and that is a compulsory experiment that you have to attend. Okay, so that part we will be demonstrating here. I will be demonstrating here, so you can go through it. You can understand it very clearly how the measurements are taken. Okay, and for the any doubts which is regarding to the practicals, we can discuss when we start our online classes. Okay, so let us start with the first experiment for today. So the first experiment that we are going to demonstrate is regarding to the focal length of convex lens. We have already studied in the theory part regarding the spherical lenses, and also we have just discussed through how the focal length of the lenses can be determined, and we are having the expression, that is the lens formula, which is used in the numerical part to find the focal length of the given lens. Okay. So here, for finding the focal length of the lens, actually we are having different methods. Okay, it's not a particular method. We have different method that we can find the focal length of a given convex lens. So why we are only considering the convex lens? That is very important. Okay, because you know that when we consider the convex lens, the number of images that we are getting for different position of the object is real, except one condition. That is when the object comes within focus and the optic center, we are getting virtual image. Remaining all cases, we are getting the real image. So that's why the need is that we have to get a result for our practical. So for that, we have to get a real image from a spherical lens, and that is only possible through the convex lens. Okay. But if we consider the concave lens, we cannot spot the image on the screen. So therefore, we cannot do any of the experiments based on the concave lens. So we are only doing the experiment that are regarding to the convex lens. Now let us understand that what are the different methods for finding the focal length. There are different methods: distant object method, UV method is the auxiliary method is the. Okay, so for our practical syllabus, we are going to discuss two methods. One is distant object method, and the second one is UV method. Okay, so distant object method is a very easy method that we can directly get the focal length with the help of a ruler and a lens. So the minimum apparatus is actually required for the distant object method. But when we go for UV method, it's also an easy method, but we need a screen, an object, then a lens holder. Like that, apparatus need is more compared to that of the distant object method. But actually the method gives us one, the focal length. The procedure for the UV method is also comparatively with the distant object method having bit more steps. So we are discussing both today, the distant object method and the UV method, to find the or to determine the focal length of a given convex lens. Okay, so before entering to the experimental procedure, so let us see what is actually the equation here given. Okay, so this equation is actually taken out from the lens formula. 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. And 1 by f, that you know, is actually not the focal length expression, it's for power. So we are finding the focal length. So you have to integrate the equation in the format of f equal to uv by u minus v. So there will be substituting the value for u and v, we will be getting the answer for focal length. Here, u will be the object distance. Object distance, you can see the figure over here. This is the convex lens that we are considering in the diagram. Okay, so we have the focal length, focus position, and the center of curvature position. When you place the object, it's very important. When you place the object you can place it at focus. The result you will be getting on the right side. Okay, that is a real and magnified image or enlarged image. But the problem is the image will be from that infinity. It is very difficult to position the real image because image is from that infinity. So here, the position for the practical case, the position of the object should be behind the focus. Okay, anywhere behind the focus, we can place the object. And as you know, we already studied about the red diagram. The images which is behind form, which is the object behind the focus, will be formed in the region, in the finite distance from the lens. So we can position the image, the rear image, if we are placing the object behind the focus. Okay, so it's very important. When you place the object, you have to place the object behind the focus. Then only you will be getting a real image which is formed on the screen. And you know the property of the image, it will be inverted. And the size of the image is depending upon the position of the object. Okay, so if you take the case that the object, suppose the object is placed between center of curvature and the focus. So here, the image will be formed on the right side. So for that, we are considering here two light rays. One is traveling parallel to principal axis. It will be passing through focus. The other one is passing through the optic center. Okay. And it travels undeviated. And here will be the image what we are getting. Okay. So if you compare the object and the image, obviously the image will be larger in size compared to that of the object. For the position, if you are placed between center of curvature and the focus. The other thing what you have to understand is, when we do the practical, we are taking a measurement. Measurement means always, as per the new Cartesian sine convention procedure, always you have to take the measurement from the lens to the object and from the lens to the image. Okay, so always our measurement should start from the optics and the lens towards the object and towards the image. Next thing is, as per the new Cartesian sine convention, when we take the measurement, we have to apply the sine. We have already studied. So if you are taking the object distance u, okay, it is measuring in opposite direction of incident ray. So it should be taken as negative. And the image distance we are measuring in the same direction of incident ray. So it will be taken as positive. Okay, so this you have to use when you substitute the value for u and v. Okay, so in this equation, u is object distance, v is image distance. So image distance already will be positive, but object distance will be getting as negative. Okay, so when you substitute here, you have to use the sine convention and you have to solve it. So therefore, when we solve, what we have to do, when we substitute the value, we will be getting as minus u v divided by minus u minus u. Okay, so you will be getting a negative value in the numerator and also a negative value in the denominator, and negative and negative will be cancelled, and finally you will be getting a numerical value which is positive. That means the focal length of a convex lens is positive. Okay, so if you want to reach to the positive, you have to substitute the values with the Cartesian sine convention. Is very very important. Not only the practical, when you do the numericals also, you have to take care of this. When you do the substitution, you have to use the Cartesian sine convention. Okay, so these are the initial theory part that we have to understand before going to the procedure. Okay, so this equation to find the focal length. The terms here, u and v. U is the object distance and v is the image distance. And for the particular object distance, we have to find what is the image distance. So we will be fixing first the object distance, which is more than focal length, and then we will find out what is the position where we are getting the clear image. And three trials minimum you have to do. Okay, because this is an experimental part, you have to do the practicals. There can be some sort of error, can be caused when you do the practicals. So to minimize the or to minimal error values, what we are doing? Minimum three times we need to repeat in the experiment. So different values of u for the same convex lens. Okay, and then we will take out for different values of u, for different values of v, and then we will be calculating the focal length, and then we will take the average of the focal length. Okay, if you are taking three trials, the three trials focal length average value will be taken out, and that will be considered as the final answer of focal length of the minimum. Okay, so hope all of you have understand the theory part of our today's experiment. So now let us go to the experimental part. Okay, so the first step what we are doing is, here our method, our experiment method, two methods. we are actually using. First, we are doing the distant object method. Okay, why we are doing distant object method? Because as I told you, the object should be placed more than the property. Okay, so we should be having an idea about what will be the reference value of propellant of the convexness that we can do by distant object method. Okay, so now first, with the help of distant object method, we will just take out what will be the nearby value or the propellant of the convex lens by the distant object method, and by using that we will do the process of UV method. Okay, so when you do the UV method and you get the final answer, then you can compare with the distant object method. Okay, so by distant object method you will be having a reference value for the convexness which can be compared with the result of UV method. Okay, so you will be getting an approximation how much you will be getting to the answer. So both the experiments together we are going to do today. Okay, so first let us go and find what is actually the focal length. Okay, that is the rough focal length by the method of distant object method, and after that we can go to the apparatus and you can start with the UV method to find the focal length. Okay, so first let us go to the distant object method. So let me introduce to the apparatus what we are required for our experiment. Okay, so this is the arrangement. So this is the arrangement that we have to use for our UV method. Okay, we have a screen, a wide screen here, a lens holder, and the convex lens whose focal length we have to determine. And here there is a source. Okay, actually it is a grid, or actually it is a wire which we are actually using here as an object. And from the behind, the light will be given to the wire glass whose shadow will be falling on the screen. Okay, so this is actually the source for us, and here is the lens whose focal length you have to determine, and this is a lens holder to hold the lens, and this is the screen, and other one is the ruler to measure the displacement, that is the object distance and the image distance. Okay, so these all are required for the UV method. Now for our distant object method, as I told you, we need only two apparatus. One is the lens and the other one is the ruler. Okay, now let us see how the distant object method is used for measuring the focal length of a given convex lens. Let's see. So here I am using the ball as the screen. Okay, so I will be focusing any distant object through the lens to the ball. Okay, so when the distant object is falling to the lens, the image will be falling on the screen, and then I will be adjusting the lens to find the better clear inverted real image on the wall. So as you can see, as I am focusing, you can see that the window, okay, which is on behind me, the window is actually focusing through the lens. Okay, so when I move the lens, you can see that the image which is falling on the screen is getting blurred and also getting clear. So what I have to do is just I want to focus the lens and find the better clear image. Okay, so what I am seeing through the lens is actually an inverted image. So I have to move the lens and I will fix a position where I am getting a clear image. So this is the position where I am getting a clear image of the window through the lens. Now next thing is I have to find what is the position of the lens on the ruler. Okay, what is the position of the lens on the ruler? And as you are seeing, you can see that it is positioned on 20 cm. Okay, 20 cm. So that is actually the position of the lens where you can get a clear image. So it shows what? The displacement between the lens to the wall. The wall is at the position of 0 on the measuring scale, and the lens is at the position of 20. So the displacement between the screen and the lens is 20 cm, and that will be considered as the focal length of this convex lens by the method of distant object method. Okay, so this is a simple experiment that you can easily find what is the focal length of the given convex lens. Okay, hope all of you had understood the distant object method. Now we have a referral value of the focal length of this convex lens, that is 20 centimeter. Okay, now let us go to the UV method and we can start with UV method. Okay, so here is the arrangement over here. As I told you, here we have the source, that is object, that is the wire goes, which is glow or shadow will be formed with the help of the light, and we have to place the lens over here, and the lens we have to place on this lens holder. Okay, so just loosen the holder and okay, after placing the lens on the holder, the next step is we have to make the displacement u. Okay, so we are fixing the value for u and then we are finding the position for the v, that means the image position we are finding. So for that, as I told you, the displacement between the lens and the source should be maintained more than the focal length. So here you can see the holder is actually the source is actually placed at a zero measurement, and I had placed the lens which is at a 40 centimeter. Okay, so it is actually the twice of the focal length that we had considered, that is the rough focal length what we got is 20 centimeter. So I had placed at a 40 centimeter. It's not compulsory you have to place at 40 centimeter. Only the thing you have to take care is that you have to place the lens at a displacement from the object of more than focal length. Okay, then only we will be getting an image on the screen. Otherwise, if you place at focus the lens, that means object and the lens displacement is equal to the focal length, what will happen? The image will be getting, but its position will be infinity. So we cannot find the position of the image very fast. Okay, so always the first trial or the trial whatever we are doing, make sure that the position of the u, that means the displacement of u, object distance should be more than the focal length. So here I had placed at a 40. Okay, here you can see the wedge is actually coinciding to the 40. And now next part is, now I had fixed the value for u. Now the u is equal to 40 centimeter, that is the displacement between lens and the object. Now we have to place the screen. Okay, so we have to place the screen and we have to find the image. Okay, so we have to find the image that we are getting very clear on the screen. So if I keep the screen very close to the lens, you can see that we cannot find any image. Exactly the two wire, a vertical and a horizontal. So exactly as a cross, you can see on the screen. So now you can see no image is actually there. So slightly you have to move only the screen. Okay, don't move the object and the lens that is already fixed. You should not move that. Only move the lens away from the, only move the screen away from the lens to find the position where you are getting a clear image of the cross. So you can see on the screen a cross, that is actually the wire goes what you are using as the source. Okay, the shadow is exactly falling on the screen. So if I try to move, you can see that it's getting blurred. Okay, so I have to adjust and to find a perfect clear image that both maximum the vertical and the horizontal line is clear. Okay, so I'm fixing this position where I can find a clear image of both the vertical and the horizontal part of the wire goes. So we will be fixing over here, and now next part is you have to take the displacement between the lens and the screen. Okay, so here when you take the displacement, first you find what is the position of the image where it is formed. Okay, so you can take out the position is somewhat near to 93 here. Okay, and here the position of the image is near to 40. Okay, so what you have to do here, you have to take the displacement here. Okay, you have to take the displacement here between the lens and the image. Okay, so you can do it as 93 minus 40. Okay, so you will be getting near to 53.
okay, 53 as the displacement, that is between the lens and the screen. Okay, so that will be taken as what? Taken as the image distance, and here object distance approximately we had fixed at a 40. Okay, so this is actually the result what we have to get on the screen, and we have to take the measurement over here. Okay, so we already fixed the value for u, and now we have find the position for a better image on the screen, and we fixed the position of the screen, and we have taken the displacement between the lens and the screen. So to take the displacement between lens and the screen, we can take out the position of the lens and you can take out the position of the screen and subtract it. As I told you, 93 minus 40, 53 you will be getting. Okay, so that 53 will be considered as the image distance. Okay, so as a calculation part, just I will show you. We have the equation for focal length, f is equal to uv by u minus v. Okay, now for the first wire, we have set u as is equal to 40 centimeter, and we got it as 53 centimeter. Okay, now substituting the value in the equation of focal length, and remember when you substitute the value for focal length, this displacement, that is displacement of u, object distance is taken as negative and image distance is taken as positive. So when you substitute here, you have to substitute as minus 40, that is u will be negative here. Okay, minus 40 multiplied with 53 divided by again minus 40 minus 53. Okay, now you have to solve for the further, multiply it, and here we have both the negative values, you will be summing up and you will be getting the numerator and denominator with the negative value, and negative and negative will be cancelled. So let us do for it. So 53 into 4, 12, 1, 21. Okay, so minus 2, 1, 2, 0. Okay, divided by minus 93. Okay, so this is actually the calculation, and as I told you here, negative and negative will be get a cancel, and you will be getting an approximation of calculation part, that is 2120 divided by 93 as the answer as approximately equal to 22.8 centimeter. Okay, so here 22.8 centimeter is actually the value we had got here, and what was the rough focal length? The rough focal length was we got from the distant object method as equal to 20 centimeter. So here you can see the difference, 22.8 centimeter and 20 centimeter. So this is what I told you, when we start doing the experiment, there will be some sort of error. It may be the aperture, that is the area of the refraction of the lens, may be having some error, or maybe the positioning, the scale, ruler, measurement may be the position, or our observation part also, where we are fixing the image or where we are fixing the screen with our observation. Sometimes it may be clear for us, but exactly it may not be clear. So some sort of error will be occurring when we do the practical experiments. Okay, so that's why I showed you the difference here. Near to 2.8 centimeter difference we are coming. So that's why I'm telling we have to repeat the experiment minimum 3 times. Okay, so the next experiment we will try to get a little more clear image compared to the first one by removing maximum error what we had created in the first. Like that 3 times if you are repeating, then 3 times repeated focal length value we will be taking out, and its mean value will be considered as the final answer for the focal length of the given convex lens by UV method. Okay, so this is one trial. So next trial, what you have to do is you have to change the position of the object. Okay, so I am just moving here the lens, and initially I had kept at a 40 centimeter, just I am changing to 45. Okay, 5 centimeter I am just increasing. So what you have to do here, according to that you have to adjust the screen here. Okay, so you have to adjust the screen here, and you have to find where you are getting a clear image. So this is a position where I am getting a clear image. So here for the second trial, u is 45, and here you have to find what is the position of the image formed, and you have to take the displacement between the lens and the screen, and that will be taken as the image distance. And the same method, when you substitute, use the sine conversion and y find the focal length, and that will be the focal length that we are finding for the second trial. Okay, like that you have to repeat it for the third trial, and three times when we complete it. When the third time when you do, make sure that we have changed the object distance. Okay, change the object distance u, and again find what is the position for a clear image v, and using the equation and do for the third trial. Okay, so when we do these three trials, then out of the three, that means the three results what we are getting, we will be taking out the answers and we will be taking the mean value, and that mean value will be considered as the focal length. There is a focal length of the given convex lens from our method of u. Okay, so here you can, after finding out the focal length from the UV method with the rough focal length, you can make an approximation, or you can make the error percentage also. Okay, so from your observation part, from the UV method and with the distant object method, how much is actually the error occurred in the calculation or in the observation. So that error we have to consider. So we are considering the final result plus or minus 5%. Okay, so it should not be more than that much. For example, if you are taking 10 centimeter, okay, if you are taking off a 10 centimeter as the focal length or rough focal length of the convex lens, it's 0.5, not 5%, 0.5% of error can be occurred. Okay, when we compare with the, if it is more than, then we have to check what is actually the mistake or what is actually the observation part that we have to find difficult to find the focal length near to the actual value of or actual focal length of the given convex lens. Okay, so this is actually the UV method that we have for our first experiment demonstration for our practicals. Okay, so as I told you, UV method, just you have to give little more care for when you find out the result. Okay, so maximum you have to give care and take out the result where you find the clear image, and that will be giving you the better focal length or better output also from the result. Okay, so the first process, that is a distant object method, will be helping you to have a referral value for the focal length of the given lens, and with that you can take out the error percentage, that how much you have made in the UV method. And the main part is, when you do the UV method, when you do the calculation part, you are using the equation of focal length, and when you substitute the value, you have to substitute with the sine convention, and the sine convention is very important when you solve for the focal length. Okay, so from the process we understood how we have to do the UV method and what are the apparatus needed and what is the procedure. Okay, and how many trials minimum we have to be, that is the three trials. The three trials we are repeating to remove the error, maximum removing the error from our experiment. That is what the purpose of repeating the trials, at least minimum for minimum for three times. Okay, so this is our first experiment, and this for the experiment for today. Hope all of you have understood the experiment, how to do it. Okay, so next day we will be continuing with the next experiment, and as I told you, if you have any doubts regarding to this, sure you can contact me, or you can clear it during the online classes, or you can contact me and ask the doubts and you can clear it. Okay. So hope all of you have understood.